Hey guys, Dr. Prometheus here, and here we are with our Bears franchise. We have a big game ahead of us, the division rivals Packers. It's the first game we end up playing against the Packers in our string of division games mixed in with the Texans and the Jaguars. So here we go, dev grade. And here it is. If four TDs are 200 yards rushing receiving for Robinson, he wants to deal with, oh, Jair Alexander. I do always forget about Jair. I'm going to commit to slow him down. Okay. Beat the Packers, throw one or fewer interceptions. Got some upgradable players here. Don't care about Rosen. Bush, I do want to upgrade because we put might put him out there in our sub packages this game. Man coverage and zone coverage and tackling. That's a good one. Jalen Johnson, of course. You ever figure out what his is a star? That's a good one. Do man coverage. And coverage recognition awareness. Do you ever figure out what Cole Kmet was? Cole Kmet is a star. Okay. Can work with that. They're both really, really young, so that's gonna help us with a lot of stuff. Here we go, baby. Superstar X Factor try for Allen Robinson. Brian Curse is falling in the draft board. Okay. If he falls anymore, it might actually help us. Wow. Might be good. The center would be the only thing good there. Okay. Let's look at the injury report for both teams. We're good all around. We're not going to bring any of them back. For the Packers, they're without Devin Funchess, Adrian Amos. That's going to be a big one. Lane Taylor, Albert Wilson, who they traded for, and DeAndre Washington. Okay. I think this PCL is actually a legit PCL tear. Maybe. I'm not sure. Kind of weird. All right, baby. Sunday. I have Packers wear their alternative classics. I'm going to wear all whites. Like. Go, baby. On EA Sports. Remember, Devonta Adams had three touchdowns last game, so. Nash gonna have to be a force in this.
Come to you from one of the truly iconic stadiums in the NFL as you get a look at Lambeau Field here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. as the Packers get set to match up with the Chicago Bears.
Here we go, baby.
Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, we look at this Packer team as we enter play here. The losers their last time out, so they'll look to make amends here.
And one of the best ways you can do that is to be at home, and they are. They're going to try and ride that home crowd and that wave of emotion to a victory.
This is kind of weird that
visitors, the Bears, they come in off the extended break from the bye.
I think it's much needed as well.
Oh, I'm thinking about the Buccaneers did play today. For a second, I was like, the Buccaneers play tomorrow in real life, but they don't. Chiefs play tomorrow, real life.
Underway from Lambeau. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Here we go with the Packer offense, guided by their defeated QB with a long list of Pro Bowls and other accolades next to his name, of course. Aaron Rodgers leading the way.
And what I loved about meeting with him before the game was talking to a guy who takes ownership of his performance. Two touchdowns, two
interceptions. All right, baby. Good play by Hicks. Good one. Good play by Eddie Jackson.
Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. And it's complete to Lewis.
Come on.
And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the
first. Come on, Eddie.
That one good for seven as this long drive continues and the chains move again. From the 13 down, they work on first and 10.
Nice play.
Immediately there. Danny Trevathan there to bring him down.
56. Check 59. Mike is 59.
On second down, here's Rodgers.
Let's go. Let's bring it.
And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. Rodgers teaming up with Lazard there for a Packer first down.
Check 59.
First and goal at the one.
Let him know. Let him know.
Bro, what?
Mercedes Lewis, the intended receiver, but it'll be second and goal. Another shot from the one on second and goal.
Four down, four down.
They'll try and run it in with Jones.
Yep.
And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. Aaron Jones, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Packers take it right down the field.
is across the 20, but not by Let's much, go, as he's marked down officially at the 21. So here the Bears
actually close out a couple windows. I think something is downloading. Here, it's kind of stuff out. There we go.
He's got to be excited about that because now he didn't just get a game plan for 1 week. He's able to work on it for 2 weeks. I can't wait to see anything special in the score for him today.
Now a throw to the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down. First carry now for David Montgomery. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave a little second and three. But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while, because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that brings us to the 33.
Oh, come at
the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. 8 yards, first down as they're able to convert. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Out of the game, they'll look to throw.
Really?
Offensive line together, get your tight end in the ball game and say, I don't care that they're number two. Let's go ahead and show them that we can run the ball anyway. Or do you do the best thing and throw the darn thing and try and get in the end zone?
Maybe that's wiser.
Tight end to the right, boy. Tight end to the right. Move.
Three down.
Rogers going to try and throw on third down. This is caught. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the line. It's a gain of six as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. Now a play fake here on first down. Blitz coming and down.
There's Dan Trevathan. We blitz. Really? You just let Lazard just body you?
Here's a dangerous Cordero Patterson. And he takes this near the 20. works their way back onto the field here for their second drive of the game. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it.
Whoops, I meant to throw that to Cole Kmet. Well.
But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work?
Let's.
I had the coverage, come on.
Thank you. Throw it away.
This is incomplete. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete. They got to get to the 23 here on third. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And Robinson with a big catch. They'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark it down at the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. A bit of a catch for him to remember. That's number 400 for his NFL career. Not a bad number at all. They'll try and run for it. First and goal. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 8 and a good first step there with second and goal coming up.
Watch out, watch out, watch out. What we got, what we got?
They'll run for it. There it is, David Montgomery.
Touchdown, Bears. David Montgomery, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bears have cut it to within a score. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there and in the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. And this will be brought ready, out to the ready, 25 as Taylor elects to not return it. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calls, they're locked in really well.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. From the 29, Rodgers got an open man. It's Valdez Scantling.
I got lucky with that. Oh, damn.
That's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Packers. Equinemius St. Brown, his second touchdown on the season. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're getting up in every direction.
And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. So the same result, had he opted for the touchback. Prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. I guess they have to feel a little gratified at least get on the board last time, but still worked.
Ah, I double tapped. Whoops.
Increase the urgency a little bit. Maybe pop up.
Didn't mean to do that.
Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Flushed out right. Now he'll pull it down. And he'll get to the 29-yard line. Brought down.
Definitely not running with Mitch, that's for sure.
Second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really
open, man.
And there it is, Cole Kmet.
Cole Kmet with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Bears draw a bit closer.
Only where he could catch it.
Taken about 7 yards deep, and this will be brought out to the 25 as Tanner elects to not return it. Number 12 back out there. Aaron and his Packer teammates set to begin their drive. And he's been good. Two first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they feel really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was just saying, now he wants the first-half hat trick, doesn't he?
Really? Gibson's just not fast enough. I was running that entire time, and that receiver is just so much faster than he is. Wow.
Assuming he stays healthy, assuming the health, should get to that 1,000-yard mark pretty easily.
the team to relax their pursuit of the ball. Meaning, if they just have a normal game, they'll get to the 1,000-yard mark. They don't have to force anything.
Come on, you got to catch that. Out of bounds.
And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. Back to back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Ready?
We gotta get the ball, D. Get the ball right here. Let's go.
Now Foles. Quick throw here, that's complete. Now the Bears gonna use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. So first and 10 now from the 30.
I took a shot here.
Going up top for Miller.
Oh, I thought he had it.
He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. And that is incomplete.
Not where I wanted that ball, but all right.
Complete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Single, single. Last number 20.
Go, go.
Hey.
The throw now on the final play. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. He's looking for Ridley again, and it's third down. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. This is up and good.
Try to get it.
Time report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports halftime report.
This is just a shootout right now.
On around the NFL. We'll get things started up at Ford Field in Detroit. And as you see,
they won a one-point game.
Thursday night, 15-14, the final in a one-point affair. From there, let's head off and check out a second game.
Dallas won.
As you see, they were winners back on Thursday night. 17-13 was the final. And then one more to highlight. Monday Night Football. That'll be a good one between the Seattle Seahawks and the Philadelphia Eagles.
Minnesota lost, okay.
In our game, it's been Aaron Rodgers, who was on target in the first half. His three touchdowns.
You do get the ball back, so that helps.
Will go to work at the 21-yard line. Back out onto the field comes Allen Robinson. Anytime a receiver
receivers over 100 yards like he is, maybe the D coordinator scratching his head a little bit. If you're the D coordinator,
Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And tough to win games if you're going to get a field goal here. They got field goal last time. And they're looking for a touchdown.
We're looking for the big chunk now because, as you know, the field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder. It puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score.
Mike 42. I got him.
On first down, he'll have to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route, the drag, and being able to run away from defenders. Hard to stick with them for that long.
Blitz left.
Better against mid, because now you're running away from someone.
Throw behind the blitz.
Into a defensive player in another zone.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards there and a first down.
Get away.
First down, here's the run with Montgomery.
Nowhere to go with that.
Second and two after that last catch. Good for Adams. Out of the gun, running with Cohen.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks.
I'm going to go Miller here. No, I'm not blitz. I don't have time. I do want to see what stats are for right now. 55.
16 and a first. There's a first and 10 at the 14 yard line.
Here we go, D.
It's just me and you.
Got it! Anthony Miller.
Too successful. And with it, they're back within a field goal. I guess the coach looked at the two-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a three-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call, and he felt good about what he had for a two-point conversion, and now they're only down three and feeling great about themselves.
And this will be brought out to the 25 as Taylor elects to not return it. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
There it is, Khalil.
Like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. It's Khalil Mack, the all-pro, in there to get him behind the line. Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move forward here on second and 14. Now a man open down the middle of the field, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Get him! Check 59.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. He'll get this to any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection of the miss might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection dropped it.
Ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it. And he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect.
58, it's Mike.
Yeah, that's what I do.
And again, it's Rodgers.
He split the zone. Wow. He's just split the safeties. Wow. That's just luck. Fell behind the blitz. And Ridley, nice play. A little bit of Darnell Mooney out here. Robinson is just open. I'm not even forcing a ball to him. He's just open. Really blitz. I'm gonna throw that over the middle. One-on-one with a safety. Good play by Hicks. Again.
Definitely worthy of applause. I remember when 500 met you.
put you on the path. A significant number.
3 yards the game check, there, check, second nine. Down.
Hey, pick your game up.
Mike 5'9".
Watch the run, watch the run.
On second down, it's Jones. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. A gain of 13, it's a first down. Now I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. Gain some yardage and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
On second down now. Nice play by Jackson.
Back at the 22. It'll go down as a 2 yard loss, and it brings up a third down. The Packers on third down. They haven't been stopped yet. A perfect 7 for 7. This will be third and 6.
Let's go, defense. And dropped.
We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching.
Throw it away.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now, but let's face it, all of our
I wanted to throw it downfield, but
they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at the premium here. Throwing again on second and 10. Fools.
Not a lot of depth there. I'll just take the first down. I wanted to go deep with it, but this wasn't the time to do it. Wow. Kenny Clark did work there. Come on, Allen.
They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. An incomplete pass on that last play. And that means he's going to come up with something here on third down.
Over there. Single receiver.
And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 30. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13. Clock running under 4 to play now as they come up on first and 10.
He's got to be there, right? He's just been having such a good game. He does. Jesus, why is he so open right now?
Game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive took a little bit of the wind out of their sails.
I don't like what I like downfield. Ordell, first down. Put out a 2 minute warning. Take a timeout. 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 Okay. We tried to do it. I was looking, didn't see anything. Kenny Clark makes a play. Kenny Clark makes a play, man. Could not punch it in, man. So we take the loss, but Allen Robinson was open most of the game besides in the red zone. Still had two touchdowns, though. Rodgers just got in the zone and just melted us. Allen Robinson, 16 receptions. He was open all day long. We had a lot of blown coverages because we just called plays where they were just not sustainable and they audible to the even better plays. It's just all it comes down to. An audible to even better plays. Yep. Superstar X Factor, you know that graphics method. Use his own ability. 10,000 XP for A Rob. Alexander was a non factor whatsoever, but just did not play good. Well, what do you want to call it? Didn't do it. Val Robinson's a 91 overall, though. Superstar X Factor. He got Ankle Breaker. Fake out rates on spin, juke, hurdle after the catch. Well, that's a good one from Allen Robinson. We go up against the Lions, who are the first in the division. We can even this out. Pull within a game, and then it's down to the last four games on who plays better. As for us, we know our schedule, but the Lions... The Lions for the Bears, Packers, Titans, Bucks, Vikings. So that's a hard stretch in the last five games for them. Packers can light up the scoreboard or go silent. Titans, the defense is pretty good. Bucks with Tom Brady. You have a chance. You do have a chance. So I will see you guys next time. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in week 13 up against the Lions fighting for the division. See you guys then.